children, welcome to grade 6 English and this is our session 4 in chapter 4, The Necklace of Pearls. And in today's session, we are going to summarize the story. And before getting into our session, let's do an energizer, that is word wheel puzzle. Yeah, this is a puzzle. Children, here there is a word wheel, right? The goal of a word wheel puzzle is that you should create as many words possible with the letters in the word wheel. But you have to follow certain rules for this, and you can only use each letter only once in a word, and every word must have the letter in the center of the wheel. This is a very interesting puzzle, right? And you have to find the 11 letter word, and they have given you the clue for that 11 letter word. And children, you can find so many words with the help of this word wheel, and after completing this, you can post your answers in grade 6 English Google Classroom. And now let's recall the story, The Necklace of Pearls. And this story was all about a poor old woman and her only son Francisco, and they both were living in steep rocky hillside of one of the islands of Azores, and they lead a very beautiful life. The boy went fishing in his little boat, and every night he used to brought home some fish for his mother to cook for dinner and also to carry into a market to sell. In this way, they lived very comfortably and happily, and they lived each other dearly. Francisco was the handsomest boy in the whole parish, with fair skin, beautiful blue eyes, and thatch of curly golden hair. And when he was 16 years old, there was an old rich man's daughter who used to smile upon him. But he thought only of his fishing boat and his mother. He did not notice the smiles. And one night, the moon was so bright, Francisco couldn't able to sleep. So he went to fishing. His mother stopped him from going fishing during the night time, and she thought that some evil will surely befall on her son. But he laughed seeing her mother's fears, and he said that, "I know how to take care of myself, dear mother, so don't worry, I will be bringing you so many fishes so that you can sell those fishes in the market tomorrow." So that his mother shook her head anxiously, and after that the boy went out for fishing during the night time in his little boat. And he quickly launched his little fishing boat, and with the peaceful waters of bay and gleamed silver pathway in the moonlight, the soft air and the gentle rocking of the little boat, it all made Francisco to fell asleep. A few moments later, the moon's rays upon his curls made them shine as if they were indeed made of gold. And not only the village maidens used to notice Francisco's blue eyes and handsome face, there was a water nymph, and she also admired him each and every day. She was invisible to the eyes of humans, so that she can't be seen by anyone there in the village, and also this boy. And she spent a lot of long hours near him, never taking her eyes from his face. And she felt very happy after seeing this boy in the fishing boat at that too during the night time. This was what she wished for, because during the daytime, no one can able to see the water nymph, and only during the night time, now the Francisco can able to see the water nymph. And she thought that he will be liking her. And she hastily arranged her own beautiful hair before a little mirror she carried with her. And also some of the strands of priceless pearls decked her lovely head were a trifle awry. That is, she felt very beautiful after seeing her hair in the mirror with the priceless pearls that was decorated on her head. And she also wore the necklaces of rare pearls which hung about her fair throat, and she seemed to be a gleam of soft light, almost like the light of the moon. And she approached the little boat and she saw that Francisco was fast asleep, and she was shocked because the boat, it may drift upon the dangerous rocks and it will lead to some danger to the Francisco. And she thought of taking him to her palace, which was in depths of the sea, that is the palace of Mother of Pearl. And she took Francisco along with her without awakening him. She thought the rocks are really dangerous, but also for one instant she thought, if she took him to the depths of the sea, how far from home Francisco would be in the palace of the Mother of Pearl in the depths of the sea, she thought. But she took Francisco to her palace. Next day, the fisherman found the empty boat in the sea. And for few hours, his mother had watched in vain for his return. But when she found that only the boat has returned, she was in very deep grief and pain. And he was the best son as a mother ever had. She mourned over and over again, and she can't able to live without him. And days passed by, week passed by, but Francisco never returned home. So this old woman not only missed her boy's loving smile, but also the fishes he caught so skillfully. There was little for the poor woman to eat if she had any appetite for there was no food for her to eat. And then many of the neighbors, they told old women that better you go to the wise man of the sea and tell him your troubles. She thought of going to the wise man of the sea, but she also know that it was a very long and difficult journey to reach the wise man of the sea, but she decided to go there. She launched the Francisco's little boat, and with the smooth seas she reached the little rocky island in the midst of the sea where the wise man of the sea lived. His tall form was outlined above the cliff. Even she can able to see him at the shore. "Well, little mother, what can I do for you?" asked the wise man of the sea. And before going there, this old woman felt very afraid and fearful of the wise man of the sea. And after seeing him, he was very kind and as well as full of great wisdom. The fear in Francisco's mother's mind vanished. And after that, old woman told the entire thing what happened for Francisco. And now the wise man said, "I know where your son is." And he was very happy. And he is very happy and delighted. And he is very well. And now, after hearing this, the old woman felt very happy. And the tears came out of her eyes in joy. And he asked whether he is entirely well and happy. "Yes, the water nymph gave him a philtre so that he forget all his past life entirely." And now only the old woman felt little okay, because she had that in her mind that even this old woman was suffering in pain and sorrow, how can her son be very happy there? She always had that in her mind after hearing what that wise man said. And now, after hearing this, water nymph had made him forget all his past, now only she became okay. And now, children, until this part of the story, you have to summarize in your English note. And after that, she kept asking the wise man of the sea how we can make Francisco come back and what can be done to overcome the power of this water nymph. And for that, the wise man of the sea smiled at her and said, "Good mother, you have to cry and you have to suffer a lot for that." And for that, the old woman asked, "What can I do?" "You can say, and I will do anything for my son to come back." And then the wise man said, "You have to cry so much so that your tears should reach the heart of the Francisco, who is in the depths of the water in the palace of that water nymph. And the old woman felt very happy and she said, I would have shed many tears and I would shed tears for the whole ocean to fill upon, she said. And now the old woman started crying and shedding tears upon the ocean. And after that, Francisco was very happy in that beautiful palace. And there were lovely gardens filled with so many flowers which were made of precious gems. And every day this water nymph used to make a garland for Francisco's golden curls and made a crown that is made of that valuable garland. And he never had a thought of the old life at a home with his mother. So he completely had the nymph's philtre done its work. And there was always a big fish swimming about the palace. And she always used to say to Francisco that this is your riding horse and you can go anywhere with the help of this riding horse. If you felt boring or tired of this palace, you can go there. You can go somewhere and you can come back with the help of this riding horse, she used to say. The water nymph always used to hide her fish tail with the help of her hair because she always had that fear in her mind, and also she was very sensitive about the fact that she had no feet and she couldn't able to wear that beautiful slippers like all those maidens in the village. And Francisco smiled into her eyes and said, how can I get bored or tired of such a beautiful palace and place like this? And in fact, after the days passed by, when water nymph felt asleep, what happened? Suddenly, one day, the water nymph felt asleep and that the Francisco thought of his mother, the little house, and how he used to live for the past 16 years with his mother. And also the fishing boat, which was his pride and joy, and the moonlight night when he had cheerfully kissed his mother and gone away never to return. He did not stop to waken the sleeping nymph and he said no word to the servants of the palace. He thought only to the wandy of the fish with a cushion of sea green satin embroidered with pearls. Quick, he cried to the fish, and then as soon as the fish went very fast, they reached the mother's house. And after seeing his mother's eyes were swollen and she can't able to even smile at him, as she can't able to see anything. And after that, after seeing Francisco, the old woman felt very happy, cheerful and with great joy, but she couldn't able to express anything because of her swollen eyes. And she asked him to promise that he would not go fishing again. And because she can't able to trust that water nymph ever again, even in the daytime. And after that, Francisco gave up being the fisherman and he became a hunter. And to make his spears, that is tools which helps to hunt, to make the spears, he used to go to the hillside and down to the edge of the water. He had grown still handsomer even after he lived in that palace of Mother of Pearl. And there was twice as many pretty maidens who cast smiling glances in his direction. But the daughter of rich man of the village won the heart of Francisco, and he had no gift to take except the birds and the animals he had killed with his own hand to that maiden. The rich man laughed at him saying these words, when my daughter marries, it shall be only to the person, that is to a man, who can bring her rich gifts. Francisco felt very sad and his heart was in deep pain. He sat upon the rocks of the edge of the water, gazing out over the water with eyes so full of tears. The water nymph saw everything, and even after, she felt very happy after seeing him after a very long time, because she was always there seeking for a glimpse of that golden head which she had so often crowned with flowers. But now her joy vanished after seeing Francisco suffering a lot with deep pain in his heart. In this picture you can see the Francisco and the maiden, and now the next morning when Francisco went to get wood to make a new spear, he found a necklace of the priceless pearls lying on the shore, and it was a gift of the water nymph. But since his heart had been touched by his mother's tears, he had entirely forgotten the water nymph. He took the gift to the maid he loved, but never a thought of the giver. He never thought of who had given that beautiful necklace, but he took the gift to the maid he loved very much. And that was the gift of water nymph to the Francisco. And it was written by Elsie Spicer Eales, and it is a Portuguese folk tale. Children, I hope you enjoy this story along with me, and you have to summarize until this part of the story in your English note. And after summarizing the whole story, you have to post it in grade 6 English Google Classroom. And children, what is the moral of the story? Mother's love is very eternal, powerful and valuable, and it is very precious. And a mother can go to any extent for the love of her children. And this is the moral you have to learn from the story. And let me tell you the home assignment for today's session. You have to create a colorful, innovative poster on describing what you have learned from the story, the necklace of pearls, and also describing some important and interesting scenes from the story. And you have to complete chapter 4 workbook page number 43, 44 and 45 after referring the story. And children, after completing your homework, post it in grade 6 English Google Classroom. And drink more water, eat healthy food, reduce your screen time, give adequate rest to your eyes, don't use mobile phones and television often, and stay home and stay safe, children. Thank you so much.